नमस्ते टू एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब वीडियो चैनल। टुडे आई विल डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन ग्राफ थ्योरी, लेक्चर नंबर 5, इन व्हिच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कंप्लीमेंट ऑफ ए ग्राफ एंड सेल्फ कंप्लीमेंट्री ग्राफ्स। नाउ वी डिफाइन कंप्लीमेंट ऑफ ए ग्राफ। लेट जी वी ई बी ए ग्राफ, देन जी बार वी ई डैश इज सेड टू बी कंप्लीमेंट ऑफ जी वी ई इफ फॉर एवरी पेयर ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट वर्टिसेस वी आई एंड वी जे इन जी वी ई, वी आई वी जे इज एंड एज इन जी बार इफ एंड ओनली इफ vi vj is not an edge in g। example, let g v be a graph, here we have 4 vertices v1 v2 v3 v4, edges are we may write here e1 e2 E3, E4. We have to construct the complement of this graph. Here we see that V1 and V2, V1, V2 be an edge, V1, V2 be an edge, that is E1. So, G bar V E dash will not contain this edge, also other edges E2, E3, E4 will not be edge of G bar V E dash. Other than these edges, number of possible edges we may draw here in G bar V E dash. So, we draw here V1, V3, edge. Here we may draw V, this edge. So, G bar V E dash will be the complement of the graph G V E. It is to remember that vertex set remains same, here G V E, here G bar V E dash, only edge set is changed, E and E dash are disjoint sets, means there will be no common edge. Here we may write edge E5, this is E5 and this is E6. V1, V3 is E5. Here V1, V3 edge equal to E5 and V2, V4 edge equal to E6. These are possible in G bar V E dash if these edges are not in G V E, then this graph will be called complement of the graph G V E. Now we shall describe that how we can sketch the complement of a graph. Since this is the given graph GVE, we have 4 vertices V1, V2, V3, V4. Vertex set is V1, V2, V3, V4. Now, maximum possible edge for these four vertices will be E1, E2, E3, E4, this is E5, this is E6. So we will have to construct G bar V E dash means firstly we have to find the edges in E dash will contain all those edges of this maximum possible edges of the graph containing vertices V1, V2, V3, V4 such that the edges do not contain in GVE. That is, E dash will contain only edge E5 and E6. So we will construct these edges E5 and E6. E5 and this is E6. In this way, we may draw the graph G bar V E dash. In short, we have to find firstly maximum possible number of edges with four vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, in which we shall have to choose all those edges which are not contained in GVE, and we will draw these edges for G bar V E dash. Here example 2, we have to construct the complement of graph GVE. Graph GVE is given here. Here we have 5 number of vertices and 6 number of edges. Now we redraw this here. Firstly, we have to draw maximum possible number of edges for vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Here we may draw this. Here this will be a new edge. This will be also new edge. This will be also new edge. And this will be also new edge. These new edges will be contained in G bar V E dash. So we draw this new, this is new V2, V3, V2, V3 is new, V2, V5 is new. V3, V5 is new edge, and V2, V4 is be the new edge. So the complement of graph will be like this. So we may write name of the edges. Here E6, here we write this is E7, this is E8, this is E9, this is E10. So this graph is G bar V E dash, and E dash is here. E7, E8, E9, E10. Now it is to be noted that if a graph G is disconnected, then its complement G bar is connected. Here G be a graph. Here we see that number of vertices be 6. Here V3 and V6 vertices are not connected with any vertices. So this is disconnected graph. Now we draw its complement, that is G bar VE dash. We know that firstly we have to draw maximum possible edges for the six vertices. Then we leave these edges V1, V2 and V4, V5. Then except these two edges, the remaining edges will be included in G bar VE dash. That will be the complement of the graph. So we may draw here from V3, V2, V3, V1, V3, V6, V3, V5, V3, V4. These edges from V3. From V2, we may draw V2, V6, V2, V5, V2, V4. And from V1, we may draw V1, V6, V1, V5, V1, V4. Already we have V1, V3. From V6, we will draw V6, V5, V6, V4. Already we have V6, V3, and already we have V6, V1. So here for G bar VE dash, we will get these edges. Vertex remaining same. So here see that G bar VE dash is a connected graph. GVE is disconnected graph, but G bar VE dash is connected graph. So for a graph, disconnected graph, we get its complement as a connected graph. Now we shall define self-complementary graph. A self-complementary graph is a graph which is isomorphic to its complement. For example, we see here, let GVE be a graph which contains 4 vertices and 3 edges. Its complement is G bar VE dash. We make its complement by drawing edges which are not in GVE. Here we may connect V4, V2. We may connect V4, V1 and we connect V1, V3. So this is the G bar VE dash. Now we examine that two graphs are isomorphic. When it will be isomorphic, then we say that this graph GVE is self-complementary. Now here we see that V2 and V3 vertices are of degree 2 here for GVE. in G bar V E dash, we see that V4 and V2 are of degree 2. So we may correspond V2 to V4 and V3 to V1. That is V2 corresponds to V4 and V3 corresponds to V1. Now we make two sets V. This is for the GVE V set and this is for the G bar VE. Here we see that V2 corresponds to V4. V2 corresponds to V4 and V3 corresponds to V1. And we have to find correspondence of other vertices. At the same time, we try to make the 1 to 1 for edge vertices of two graphs. Here we see that V2, V3. Here V2 corresponds to V4 and V3 corresponds to V1. So V2, V3 corresponds to edge here V4, V1. Next, since V2 corresponds to V4 and here we take V1, V2, V1. Already we have taken edge V2, V3. Here V2, V1. This corresponds to V2 corresponds to V4, V1 corresponds to V2. V1 corresponds to V2. That is V4, V2 edge. Already we have taken V4, V1 edge. So here will be V4, V2 edge. Now, V3 corresponds to V1. V3 corresponds to V1. And V3 corresponds to V1. We have already taken V1, V4 here. So V1, V3. So we may write there V1 corresponds to V2 and V4 corresponds to V3. We see that F1 is 1-1, F1 is 1-1-2 and also F2 is 1-1-2. Therefore, GVE is isomorphic with GVE is isomorphic with G bar VE dash. Therefore, GVE is self-complementary graph. Therefore, GVE is a self-complementary graph. Now we give example 2 for self-complementary graphs. Let GVE be a graph which contains 5 vertices. We shall make the complement of this graph G bar VE dash. Firstly, we take V4, vertex V4, and we draw edges which are not contained in GVE. V4, V5 already contains in GVE. So we join V4, V1. V4, V1. We join V4, V2. V4, V2. Already we have V4, V3. So we will not draw the edge. Now we take V5. We join V5, V3 and also join V5, V2, already we have V5, V1. So we will not draw this. So V5, V3, V5, V2. We take V1 here. Already we have V1, V5. So we draw V1, V4 already we have drawn. So V1, V3. V1, V3. From V2, we have already drawn V5, V2. So we will get the complement of this graph is G bar VE dash. Here we see that this is the vertex sets of GVE and G bar VE. Here we see that F1 is 1-1 on 2. Also in edge set, also we see that edge set F2 function is 1-1 on 2. Firstly, we have to see the nature of the degree of the vertices. We see that each vertex of both graphs be of degree 2. So we start from anywhere and we get F1 is 1-1 on 2 and F2 is 1-1 on 2. Therefore, this is the correspondence between vertices, and this is corresponds between the edges. V1, V2 edge, here V1, V3 edge, and similarly other edge. So GVE is a isomorphic to G bar VE dash. So GVE is self-complementary graph. Now we shall prove a theorem. Prove that graph G is self-complementary, then G has 4k or 4k plus 1 vertices where k is an integer. Let number of vertices in the graph G equal to n. Given that G is self-complementary, therefore G is isomorphic to its complement G bar. That is, G is isomorphic to G bar. For the isomorphic character, G and G bar must have equal number of vertices as well as equal number of edges. Since G has n number of vertices, so maximum degree of a vertex will be n minus 1, as one particular vertex may be connected with remaining n minus 1 vertices with n minus 1 edges. So total number of maximum edges will be n multiplied by n minus 1. Since one vertex will get maximum degree n minus 1, so n vertices will get maximum degree n into n minus 1. Since one edge gives 2 degree, therefore number of edges will be, maximum number of edges will be n into n minus 1 by 2. This number of edges will be distributed equally to G and G bar. So each G or G bar will get n into n minus 1 by 2 divided by 2 number of edges, that is n into n minus 1 by 4 number of edges. Therefore, here we see that this is the number of edges. Since number of edges will be a non-negative number. So 4 must divide n or n minus 1. So n will be equal to 4k or n minus 1 will be 4k. K is an integer. Implies that n equal to 4k or n equal to 4k plus 1. Proved. Now we solve a problem. Can a graph with 7 vertices be isomorphic to its complement? If n be the number of vertices of a graph, the graph will be self-complementary if it is isomorphic with its complement. For self-complementary graph, we know that n equal to 4k or n equal to 4k plus 1. Here given that n equal to 7. 7 equal to 4 multiplied by 1 plus 3. So 7 is not equal to 4k or 7 is not equal to 4k plus 1. So a graph having 7 vertices may not be isomorphic to its complement. Thanks for watching my video. If you are satisfied with my presentation and contents, then please click on like button and do subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.